Hello everyone, back again with another video for this week's lesson. This is another recap of something that we've already learned. Today we're going to be talking about triangles, or right triangles. This is last week we kind of talked about the trig ratio using right triangles, sine, cosine, and tangent. But today we're going to talk about the Pythagorean theorem and special right triangles. So as we know, the Pythagorean theorem is just a squared plus b squared is equal to c squared, and a is going to be one of your sides, b is one of your sides, and c is going to be the hypotenuse. And then our special right triangles are either 30, 60, 90, or 45, 45, 90. So if we have a 30, 60, 90 degree triangle, our smallest side, of course, is going to be across from 30, and we're just going to call that a value x. And then the next to the largest angle is going to be across from 60, and that's going to give us x square root of 3. And then to get the hypotenuse, we can just double the smallest side. So that's why we have 2x. And then if we have a 45, 45, then since these two angles are the same, that's going to give us a isosceles triangle. So these two sides are going to be the same. So we have x, x, and then the hypotenuse is going to be x square root of 2. So if you can, pause the video and go ahead and take those notes. And if you should already have them in your notebook, but if not, just go ahead and take those notes. Okay, so let's move on to our first example here. We're going to start with special right triangles, and we're going to end with the Pythagorean theorem. So here we have, this says find the value of A and B, and they give us a special right triangle of 30, 60, and 90. Now, remember, if you go back here, so let's look here. If we have a 30, 60, 90 degree triangle, then across from 30 is going to be the smallest side, but the hypotenuse is actually double that side. So if you look here, they've given us the hypotenuse. So the hypotenuse is equal to 2x. And to get the value of x, then we need to divide by 2. So in this particular case, we know that our 14 is going to be equal to 2x. And if we divide both sides by 2, that means x is equal to 7. So that means my b is going to be equal to 7, because that's going to be that value of x across from 30. So B is equal to 7. And then to get the value across from 60, you just take the value of X, right? And you place that in front of the square root of 3. Because this is the value of 60, so we just take X and plug it in front of the square root of 3. Well, in this case, X is 7, so the value of A is just going to be 7 square root of 3. And then we're done. And now let's look here at this example right here. We still have a special right triangle. We have 30, 60, and 90. You can pause the video at this point to see if you can find the value of C. But if not, I'm going to go ahead and do that for you. So again, remember, across from 30, we have the value of X. And this is my right triangle, and it's always going to be 2x. So if my x value is equal to 10, then my c is going to be equal to 2 times 10. So c is just equal to 20. And again, I just use this. This is what you're going to be referring back to. Again, they gave us the value across from 30, which was x. So the hypotenuse is going to be 2 times that value, which is going to be 2x. And so that's what I use this triangle right here. So again, X is the value across from 30, which is 10. And to get the hypotenuse, I just double that value. And that only works when you're doing special right triangles of 30, 60, and 90. All right, so let's look at another example here. This time we have another special right triangle. And so for this special right triangle, it is actually a 45, 45, 90. So that means that your two sides are going to be equal. And so in this case, if this length here is 4 inches, then that means that this side also has to be 4 inches. And then to get the hypotenuse, you always take the value of the side and you place that in front of the square root of 2. And so that means the hypotenuse is going to be 4 square root 2. And this problem is actually asking us to find what is the perimeter. So that means we have to add up all the sides. So we're going to have 4 plus 4 plus 4 square root of 2. And so we can combine these because they are like terms. We cannot combine this one, this term with the other two because the other terms does not have a square root of 2 in it. So this is just going to be 8 plus 4 square root of 2. And that is the perimeter of this special right triangle. All right, so we have one more example. All right, so we have a triangular garden. It has one side of 8 feet. So this side here is 8 feet. And then it has another side that's going to be 6 feet. So that's the smallest side here. And now we want to know what's the length of the longest side, and that's going to be x. So in this case, we're going to be actually using the Pythagorean theorem. Because we don't know what the angles are here. We don't know if this is a special right triangle or not, so we don't have the angles. And so we're going to be using a squared plus b squared is equal to c squared. And so we know that our a is going to be 64. So we have, that's why we have a squared. My b is going to be 6. So that's why I have 6 squared. And that's going to be x squared because in this case, my x is represented, my c is represented by x. So 68 times 8 is 64. 6 times 6 is 36. So I get 100 is equal to x squared. And so I want to get the value of x because that's the longest side. So I need to take the square root of both sides. Now, when you take the square root of both sides, you get plus or minus 10. But we know that we cannot have negative length, so x is just going to be equal to 10. So again, this is a recap, guys, of our special right triangle and the Pythagorean theorem. So it should not be that difficult, but of course, if you have any questions, you can always email me and I'll be happy to answer those questions. Hopefully, this video was helpful to you. And with this video, there will be a short little quiz that is also uploaded to Canvas that you will need to complete by Thursday of this week. So please make sure you do complete that quiz as well. Thank you guys. Hopefully all is well. Have a great week.